Evening, 0 pence here, and in front of you are two bits of fun I had today with some very old but broken Sheffield steel knives, and I decided that I would make something different because the ends of these have been used as pry bars and all sorts, and I was very lucky to get a good bit of steel out of this one here, because it was absolutely mangled, and this one has been, as you can see, if you look at it, it's been polished, but it's got rather a coarse finish because someone tried to clean it up with some very, very coarse sandpaper. But fortunately, the logo is intact. This one is around about the 1950s because the way the logo is been done by machine, and this one is turn of the century, I think, and it's got white stainless in it. So, two very different but the same knife, and they're not knickers, they're peg knives. And because I was asked by someone about it and what they were, I decided to actually make two peg knives, because the handles are in good condition, so why spoil it? And the blade and the logos are absolutely gorgeous, they really are. One is Thomas Ibbotson Owlet, Sheffield, England. That's got stainless on it. And this one is English Cutlery, Firth Stainless. It is a beautiful logo. Beautiful. So that's what I've been doing for a bit of fun today, because I was sitting in a chair by the fire and I'd finished off the knife that I'm about to show you, so I needed something to do for a couple of hours, so I just decided to make these. And these, because they cost me nothing and I actually pulled them out of a skip because some people were doing their house, emptying their house out, and they just stuffed this all in a skip, so I decided to rescue a couple. I asked permission first, I didn't go skip diving, I actually did ask permission and they said yes I could, so here you are. These are they. You've got my logo on the side as well, because I repurposed them. And then there is this and this is my kind of Moira-esque knife that made from some bits and pieces. As you see, there's some tape still down here on the by the hilt. I've got to clean it off, but as it was getting dark, I thought I'd make this before anything else, as you can see. So there's the textured Scandi grind, and brass plate, and that is tapped dyed, and very, very tight on there. Plus of Gorilla Glue is holding it all together as well. That is a piece of brass, piece of Indian rosewood, a piece of antler, another piece of brass. This wood don't ask me what it is. I put it away in a box and I didn't wrap it in the bit of paper that it came in, unfortunately. But it is beautiful. It's got lovely salmon pinky colour, as you can see. And all the back of this is, if I can get a good look, excuse the state of my hands, but unfortunately the glove that I was using to coat my hands split and Gorilla Glue got in, and I've just called this one a Scandi. And it does look nice, and it's all textured, as you can see. Coin's nice, very sharp, and it's stainless. Here's the boss at the back, and you can see how it attaches on there, and that is bolted onto there. I think it's come up really, really nicely. I'm very pleased with it. And it goes into a sheath. There it is. It's really nice. It's just a halfback sheath. Put the piping stitch up the side. And it's very, very strong way of doing it as well. Hope you like it. I'll take some steals. So 0 pence. Thanks for watching. Catch you later.